the Justifiable Noize Project.
And this is Andre with the Justifiable Noize Project. Today we don't have our buddy Kyle. We wanted to shoot very quickly an impromptu video. And this is part of our Pass the Peace segment.
Yeah.
And the Pass the Peace, this Pass the Peace segment is about gun violence.
Yes, we are really, first of all, before we even start, just want to extend our condolences and our prayers to the many families who lost loved ones over this last few weeks and even beyond. I mean, obviously the news has talked about, the shooting at the Garlic Festival, El Paso, as well as in Dayton, Ohio. But just in general, I know my family has been impacted by gun violence 10 years ago this past February. A nephew of mine was at out with friends and was shot, was not the intended target, but shot and killed, just trying to socialize. And so it's definitely something that's close to my heart.
I definitely cannot say that anybody directly has been affected by gun violence in my immediate family. However, it would be remiss of me to say that it doesn't touch, the tentacles do not come very close to home. You know, whether it be here in the United States, it can be right here in, we're in Jersey City at Exchange Place, but our backdrop is New York City. There's gun violence in Jersey City. There's definitely gun violence in New York City. When I travel abroad, you definitely have gun violence in places such as London that you sometimes see me in when I'm visiting family or just going to see a football game. It may not be as prevalent as it is here because there are a lot more guns on the street here, but one death is one too many, whether it be somebody that's committing a crime or the crime is being committed on someone else. You know, gun violence is definitely something that needs to be eradicated today and as soon as possible.
Absolutely. And so, you know, just thinking about all of the issues that are happening around this gun violence, I have said many times that for me, when I realized that our country and particularly our legislators, who are really supposed to be for the people, did nothing when the Sandy Hook school shooting happened, when the little babies, you're talking about, they were 5, 6, I think 7 years old, the most of them, and you know, the educators were killed. If you can't legislate when babies get killed, then you are not going to legislate anything. I don't know what has to happen for our legislators to understand that your, and I think it's Second Amendment, so excuse me if I'm wrong, so your right to carry and bear arms, why do you need that? For most people who are carrying arms, who want to have that right, who feel like somehow making it tougher for the average person or anybody to get a gun is somehow going to reduce their right as a citizen to be able to carry a gun. I don't know what they're thinking about, and if you think about it, I would really poll those people and ask them, you know, how many times since you've had, you know, been carrying a gun, have you actually had to defend yourself with that gun? I'm sure it's not going to be a lot. And so we need to do something about this. This is a horrible situation. Someone posted on Facebook that, people can get a gun easier than they can get health care in this country. And it's just ridiculous, and it's really a sad situation, and we need to do something about it. And the way that we do something about it is with our vote.
With our vote and our voices. You touched on the Second Amendment. So let's just talk about it. The interpretation.
Man, I got that right.
Yeah. No, you're absolutely right. The Second Amendment, you know, I like to say it's very straightforward. Other people happen to have their own interpretation of what the Second Amendment is. But very briefly, if I take a look at it, it says a well-regulated militia necessary to secure a free state right to bear arms should not be infringed. So let's stop there. Regulated militia is necessary for a free state. So if indeed, and I just did some real quick research, if indeed in 2018 the United States spent $690 billion, so let's say $700 billion, just on US military, then let's take a look. Same year, 2018, spent $10 billion on the FBI. Same year, spent $82 billion on the CIA and intelligence budget. $5 billion on the US Justice Department. Now, I do believe if I count all that up, that's about $800 billion. That money can definitely be spent to provide the necessary militia to create a free state. The free state meant here in the United States. Now, I am an advocate of a person owning a gun. I have a gun permit. I have a gun. That being said, I'm not telling you that people should not have the right to bear arms, so I'm not taking any of that away and not looking to take anybody's rights away. But what I am saying is, I don't think that anybody needs high-powered guns and multi-producing
rounds of bullets,
ammo, to just have to go hunting, which, you know, that's why you have it, or in the case of home invasion, because definitely if you're a homeowner and you have a gun, that's the reason that you're giving for getting a gun. You're saying, hey, for home invasion, to protect myself, protect my family, and maybe my friends if they live there. So that needs to be addressed. Eliminate that. Now, some of the things that we're hearing right now in the current atmosphere is the possible, they call it what, red law rules, and I may be chopping up the title. If you give me a second, I'll flip my page very quickly. Red flag laws. Now, red flag laws basically subjugates things to the states. That's where the states would work. If they find a person that is deemed a danger to themselves or to others, a judge would remove all firearms from them. So the judge can do that for a temporary period of time and revisit it. Now, I don't think that's enough. I do believe that we have to delve deeply into the major problem of gun violence, and the major problem of gun violence is loose laws. My opinion, I didn't talk to Audrey about it, but I definitely would say to Audrey, hey, there should be some type of universal check. Universal check, the same way we have passports, the same way we definitely look and say that people, if indeed you're buying a car that has to be seatbelts, hell, you know, you protect yourself if indeed you're having sex with someone and you don't want to have a child or you don't want to catch an STD. You actually then use a condom, or a woman has their own device to use within them. So if you have protections of that ability, why not have the protection for a gun? You can have, you know, one thing that the NRA, which is the National Rifle Association, has been fighting against, is to have guns that have the technology that can only be utilized by the person that's using the gun. So why not incorporate that? But most importantly,
who's authorized to use it?
That only authorized to use it, correct. So why not have that technology incorporated? And at the same point in time, why not have stricter gun rules? Because you don't want to go from state to state having one gun rule, you know, very strong in New Jersey. And then if you start looking at other states, let's say, for instance, and I'm going to name them, Alabama, Mississippi, Georgia, North Carolina, South Carolina, very lax rules. You can look at Indiana just as well. They have very lax gun rules. And you don't want to have neighboring states having that problem with people trafficking guns. Why does New York City have a lot of crime and it's committed with guns? It's for the mere fact that people traffic guns. If the laws are not strong in other states, well, it just makes sense. You go and get the guns from the other states, and who's going to stop you? There's nobody there unless somebody happens to be following you for a necessary reason. Then you can bring those guns right back into your own state. So that's the key thing, to lessen the violence from the utilization of guns in the hands of people that shouldn't have it. And we forgot about criminals that should not get a second chance to have a gun, and neither somebody that has some type of mental disability.
And particularly these semi-automatic weapons that really only need to be used in times of war. We don't need those out here. No one should have access to that. It's not necessary, and we need to do something about this.
And at the same point in time, look at raising the rates. If I said you create a federal law, raise the rates on it. It has nothing to do with your right to vote and be able to vote at 18. It should be somewhere roughly around the age of 21. That we're not talking about the right to vote. We're talking about the right to carry something that can kill you. So if that be said, those are some of my suggestions that I think that should be used, and just wanted to touch on. I could talk about, you know, also the loopholes that are used inside the gun shows, because in gun shows, if Audrey happens to have a few guns and she's not selling for profit, she would never need a license. Other people that have licenses, they go through the federal government, and there's a background check. but people, if it happened to be Audrey and she happens to be selling just a few guns here or there, she would never need that. There's nothing to trace. There's no background check. Along with that, and I need to let my friend Audrey in to say a few words. Along with that, have a longer period of time. Right now, I think the background check is about three business days. Go to about maybe 7 business days on the background check. There's nothing wrong waiting a few days to make sure that you're putting the gun in the right person's hand. What do you think? Hey, my partner in crime got sick while we were finishing up the last bit of the filming. I just want to make sure that everybody got the gist of what we were saying regarding gun violence and laws that need to be amended. Hopefully that was taken into consideration, or you will take that into consideration. That has been passed the peace. Stop the gun violence, change the gun laws, and this is the Justifiable Noize Project. We're out of here. Take care.